You're up to date with all of the results of the 110 metre hurdles. We'll do that very shortly. The next event on the track, the 800 metres, there are eight heats of that. And Curtis Robb already preparing to go in the first heat. And we can now give you that result of the last heat of the horse. Alan Johnson, the world champion, 13.27. Valley, the Cuban, 13.29. Van der Kuyf of Australia, 13.49. And Melic, 13.51. They're the four qualifiers. And Italic, 13.68 in six. Not quite as quick as he ran this morning. Let's have a look at the overall qualification situation. Creer, the fastest qualifier, 13.14. Johnson, the world champion, Swartoff, Valley. Jackson, the fifth fastest qualifier. Peters, Swift, the number three American. Kazanov, the Russian. Itong, the Chinaman. Bat of Cuba, Van der Kuyf of Australia. Foster, Melick, Elizabeth, Boroy, and Clarico. Jarrett falling in his second round heat takes no further part in this competition.
Well, now we come to the first round of the men's 800 metres. There are eight first round heats, and the qualifying is tough. The first two go through as of right in the first into the next round, plus the eight fastest losers. Barbosa goes in lane one, the veteran Brazilian, twice an Olympic finalist, never in the medals. Asinga Suriname in two. Curtis Robb, Great Britain, in three. Sixth in the Olympic Games of 92, rather. Damel of Germany, one of the fastest men in the field, a German champion. Rodal, another fast man from Norway. And then we've got this unpronounceable Madagascan, Rakoto Arimanada. And I hope it's not a close finish. And David Matthews goes on the outside, the Irish champion, three times. Brendan Foster's looking forward to that one.
The tiny Madagascan, I don't think, will feature largely in this race because it's a class field. When you look at it from Curtis Robb's point of view, well, to be honest, 4 years ago, you would have said his sixth place was the beginning of the future of British middle distance running. Sadly, he hasn't quite fulfilled that potential, but the good thing that I like about the Liverpool Harrier is that on the big occasion, he always puts in a good performance. I hope he's acclimatized pretty well out here. I certainly have information that he has, and we're looking forward to Curtis's run.
Asinga Suriname, you just saw Curtis Robb, the 3-H champion, Liverpool Harrier. He's had such a bad time with injuries and illness. That's Damel, one of the fast men, 144.71 this season, the German champion. Rodal, so consistent. Second in the European Championship last year from Norway. That's your man, Rakoto Arimanada from Madagascar, 147.52 this season, and David Matthews on the outside. He's done 144.82 this season. You didn't see Barbosa on the inside, but you've seen a lot of him over the years. He's now 35. Never seems to get a medal. Tactically, he never seems to have matured. Tends to front run, goes wild for about 600 meters, and then tries to hang on. Curtis Robb interrupted his medical studies for Olympic preparation. 800 meters then, two laps of the track, the first bit run in lanes, they break at the beginning of the back straight. Robb's got off fairly quickly, but so too is Asinga of Suriname. Suriname fast at the Olympic Games 4 years ago. On the inside, inevitably, Barbosa goes again. Loves to get in front.
Well, you said about him having not learned and matured tactically over the years, but the one thing about him is he always runs as fast as he possibly can. He usually starts and runs the first lap. extremely quickly, and although Curtis is at the back of the field, I think the pace of the first 200 meters was such that he's probably judging the pace more evenly than anyone else. So that's not a bad position for Curtis Robb to be in. As long as he keeps out of trouble and doesn't go, try and go through on the inside, he needs a run on the outside, but there goes Barbosa.
Awkward place to the bell. And in last place, 50.79 is fast. Barbosa leads. Matthews of Ireland in second place. Then the Norwegian, the German, Demel and Rodal together. And Robb beginning to move. Going on the inside. Is that wise? He could run into a wall. But he's found space. Temporarily. Barbosa still leads. Demel in second place, and Rob's found his way through. The first two only sure to go through. And actually, the German's back in fifth, Demel. It's Rodal who's come through. And Rodal takes Rob home, and these two so well clear of a good class field, it's almost unbelievable. Rodal looking good, though. Rob in second place, certain to qualify. 1:45.31. He played a dangerous game. Right at the back of the bell, the first lap was fast. He looked for space on the inside, found a bit, and then found his way back to the outside. Dangerous, but it's worked out.
Well, the fact that the pace was very strongly set by Barbosa means that Curtis Robb, in laying off the pace on the first lap, had a much more even run for his 1:45. And I'm delighted to see Curtis running through. Rodal will be a danger to anyone, both in the semi-final tomorrow and then eventually in the final. But that was a uplifting run by the Liverpool Harrier. And if you look at him, he moved into the right place at 200 meters. He checked over his shoulder that no one was coming with a fast run. And sixth place in the Olympic Games last time around. This will give him the confidence boost that he so desperately needs.
Actually, although he hung off the pace, and as you say rightly, it was faster than the first 400 metres, going on the inside was dangerous, but he got away with it. And looking around, he looks very, very composed indeed. Barbosa, well, I can't understand the man of his experience and ability running the way he does.
Well, he thinks of distance running is just about running as fast as you can for as far as you can, but he usually runs out of steam in the last 100 metres. But Curtis Robb, I'm delighted to hear a message from the trackside where Curtis Robb has just spoken to our liaison man, Murray Plant, and said he feels really confident, nothing wrong, felt really good and ran well.
Barbosa, David Matthews of Ireland in fourth place. They must wait to see if they go through as fast losers. 1:45.31, the winning time.